My main three priorities are roads, water, and plantation of trees. First thing is, every MP is allotted some funds for developing his constituency. That funds has to be utilized in a proper way. If the funds are insufficient, request the center and the states to grant more so that the projects are being implemented. And the projects which are given, it has to be to a certified or an authorized person who is capable of doing a commendable job, especially the roads, because the lay, if a road is laid within 3 months, it vanishes.
Okay.
A scheme or something has to be brought in whereas that contractor should be held responsible that the roads will be intact at least for 5 years. My simple suggestion is that 10% of retention fee has to be kept so that the contractor does a better job. Regarding water, I have been interacting with the BW or the SSB authorities so that they regulate the water flow to the complete area of Bangalore. I'm not just talking only for Bangalore Central, because few places I've been seeing in Bangalore, water is just overflowing, and some places we don't get a single drop of water. So for this, I'll be interacting with the BWSSB authorities and make sure that alternative areas are supplied so that every citizen of Bangalore gets drinking water for his basic needs. And the next thing is plantation of trees, which I've been doing as a rotarian. We have been doing it regularly. Every year during June and July, minimum 1,000 trees are planted in the localities. We identify different localities. Accordingly, we plant the trees and tell the residents of that particular locality to take care of the trees by pouring water or something to keep Bangalore clean, green. Presently in our country, divide and rule has become the law of the land. That's the politicians. There should be some constitutional amendments wherein all the youth of the country make some progress in telling this government, whichever government it is, these are the things we need, these are the things you have to do. So some constitutional amendments have to be made. The next major thing is villages. Villages has been ignored to the core in our country. Every poll comes, promises are made, but never ever anything is being done. I personally have been to many villages in Karnataka when I'm doing these rotary programs. Even they don't have basic needs, so we have provided them, toilet on wheels, mobile toilets. So that is a pathetic condition of the villages in Karnataka itself. Then when you think about all of India, it'll be much worse. So these are the issues which I'll be raising in case I get elected to the parliament. In 2002, I was in Indian Navy from 1976 to 1992. After that, I started my own business in 1994. In 2002, I became a Rotarian. Once I started becoming a Rotarian, it's an NGO organization, and we have worldwide 33,000 clubs throughout the world. So our main aim is, first, we take care of the students. We distribute free notebooks, bio sand filters, school benches, and what are the basic necessities required for them. Mainly educating the rural masses, it's become very difficult as we try to go and convince these people, but this political interference is too much, wherein we cannot. So it's a bit embarrassing. That's one failure in my life, which I couldn't succeed, but hopefully I'll try till whatever time limits are possible, with the help of especially the youth. I'll create a separate website, email ID, I'll give my telephone numbers, I'll show the residents everything to the public so that anytime I'll be available 24/7, if not personally, at least through mails, phone calls, anything, so that they can air their grievances or suggestions, whatever they come up with, I'll be available to them. First and foremost, implement the promises made. As I said earlier, whatever the funds being allotted, utilize that. In case it's insufficient, request the center and the state. These are the projects I have promised and I have taken care of. These are the projects which are finished, which are semi-finished. So I request you to please grant some extra funds to complete the project. Corruption is deeply rooted in our Indian political system, which can never be wiped out. If some person tries to wipe out, he'll be wiped out. So it's a difficult question to answer, but this is a fact every Indian is facing. Without corruption, nothing works in this country.
What about the next problem that was recognized? Terrorism.
Terrorism is the main concern of the country. It's not just across from the borders, in all the borders, it's within also. The main problem is sharing of information is not proper between the state and the center, and youth get influenced because of money, and they tend to get into terrorism because of the lucrative offers given by the terrorists.
So what do you plan to do as a member of parliament on terrorism?
I have to educate the poor, the youths, make sure the poor get whatever benefits they need, youth get some employment or give them some self-employment so that they don't indulge in such activities as terrorism. First thing is, as a Rotarian, I can reach to all the masses concerned, right from the rag pickers to the bureaucrats. That is the benefit of being a Rotarian. So I know the difficulties faced by the rural masses, especially the villagers, all the slum people, everything. Because I roam around almost 6 months, 3 to 6 months of my own this thing. I leave my business and go do rotary work, that's community service. So I can address this thing. At present, it's very difficult to say about the employment concern because of the current recession. Maybe by December, things should improve and the employment should start again, because it's a downturn now. People are being given pink slips in most of the organizations. So presently I cannot comment on that. Only because I have spoken to the FKCSA president, Mr. Muralidhar, certain all the organizations, Bangalore Management Association president, Mr. Ramanan, everybody I have spoken to them regarding this. And basically they're telling you have to sustain at least for a year or so. Then yes, because presently every employee himself is in a pink slip, most of the employees. So on that basis it will be slightly difficult.
What about your stand on moral policing?
Moral policing, I'm fully against it, provided it's within limits. Elect a person, whichever party he is from, trust him so that he delivers what he promises.